For me, flowers are this momentary explosion of color and life. There's vibrancy to it. There's this buzz and hum of life all around you. The central piece of that are the blooming plants.
You're in a shady forest and you come upon a brightly lit meadow and you just see the flowers in the pool of light. And there's a connection that you make there, just in your heart, a spiritual connection to the world. The fire follower flowers are those that germinate following a fire. They have a very short time to grow and be pollinated and set their seeds.
We've been working on a project funded by the Yosemite Conservancy to study fire following rare species that lay dormant in the soil, coming out immediately after the fire, and have a short window when they're apparent and able to be documented.
We're in the footprint of the El Portal fire, which occurred in 2014 near the community of Foresta at the western edge of the park. So we've hiked through some chaparral, a lot of burnt sticks and everything like that, and we found Congdon's woolly sunflower, Areophyllum congdonii.
This individual is very special because it's rare in space. It only occurs in Mariposa County and nowhere else in the world, but it's also rare in time. These seeds could have been dormant for 50 years, and they were just waiting for this moment to come out. These opportunities are rare to be able to get out into the field and find where these things truly are on the landscape, because it's hidden from us the majority of time.
Because we have suppressed wildfires for a very long time, some areas in the Sierras haven't burned for 100 years, and we have a huge buildup of woody debris on the ground.
I go into areas that I know haven't burned in a very long time. It feels like they should burn. They're ready to burn. And it's not a question of if, it's just a question of when. Whether that's a lightning strike or, you know, a careless campfire that causes it, the system is set up to burn. When that happens, it changes everything.
The first year after the fires, you come back and you think it's a moonscape. The second year, you come back and it's completely transformed. There's lupin as far as the eye can see. Just fields of blue, and then fields of pink or fields of yellow.
Another species that we look at, the pansy monkey flower, it's got a 100-year-old record in Yosemite Valley, but it hasn't been documented since 100 years ago. So have we lost that species because the seeds have gone unviable because they've been laying dormant for so long? Or would regular fire coming back into the valley encourage those species to bloom again? We don't really know what the lifespan of these seeds are in the soil.
Pulsia heterochroma was one of them, which our park botanist told me, oh, there's probably like a few scattered plants here and there. I've seen it like on ridges. And I come up into this area, I'm like, oh, here's one. I keep walking and it keeps going up the mountain and it's everywhere. And it is an amazing thing. To come across something that not everyone can see, that may not be there again until the next fire.
You can't help but be struck by the beauty of them. And then on the next level, I get a satisfaction out of investigating the tree of life and how each of these players are interconnected with each other and how they have developed over time to really shape the whole world around us.